And now we're finally going to address the issue that everyone has been waiting for. First time doing bank reconciliation with a frequently used account that has never been reconciled before. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Many people who start reconciling face this exact condition. Imagine you have been using a bank account for several months before you started recording transactions into QuickBooks. You then started using QuickBooks to record transactions in this bank account. You never reconciled and used the account for several months. Now you want to start reconciling. Does that sound familiar? Well, if you were using the bank account for a long time without reconciling, and then you started using QuickBooks or QuickBooks Online for a long time, probably you never entered a beginning book balance. Now, usually the beginning book balance is never entered in a case like this, because we were using the bank account for a long time before we started QuickBooks. When we started using QuickBooks, we knew what the bank balance at the moment we started, and there's always a difference between the QuickBooks balance and the bank balance for uncleared transactions at any given moment. We do not know what the book balance would have been at the moment we started using QuickBooks. So people just skip this and do not enter a beginning balance. So let's look at what happened at the startup. We knew when we started using QuickBooks what the bank balance was because it was listed clearly on the statement. But we could not know what the book balance would have been because we just started using QuickBooks. We then proceeded to record every transaction in the bank statement properly in our QuickBooks records, and the same transactions that were recorded in the bank statement were recorded in the QuickBooks records. But unfortunately, the balance was never the same because we never started with the same number. Now when we go to reconcile, there's a big difference between the book balance and the bank balance, and it must have been caused by the beginning balance that was never entered into QuickBooks Online in the first place. So when you do your first month's bank reconciliation, you have to adjust for the fact that the book balance at the beginning was never entered. That's why it's called the beginning balance adjustment. The difference in the first month's bank reconciliation must be from the beginning book balance that was never entered. So, let's imagine you have been using the bank account for a long time, and then you started using QuickBooks Online for a long time. And in a case like this, when you start reconciling, you usually pick a specific moment to start doing bank reconciliation. And in this example, let's imagine you start reconciling at the end of April because you want May to be perfect. So what steps do you do in a case like this? Well, it's very simple. You only do two specific steps. First, you mark all transactions as cleared. Then when you finish doing your reconciliation, make a beginning balance adjustment. And both of these steps take 2 seconds if you're using QuickBooks Online or using QuickBooks Desktop. So let's imagine that May is the first month that we need to make correct. Therefore, April is the first physical bank reconciliation that we do. And when we go to do April's reconciliation, the first thing we do is clear all past checks and deposits, and we do that by marking them as cleared. Now we do this because we are assuming that all past checks have cleared. And you may well ask, how can we assume that all of the past checks, and quite frankly, all of the past deposits or any other transactions, have actually cleared the bank? Well, let's think of the context of the situation that you're in. The only reason we start reconciling in the current month is because we do not have time to go back and reconcile from the beginning. So, if we cannot check everything, we can only proceed from what we do know. There's no evidence that there is a mistake, because if there is evidence, then the mistakes would be fixable and probably would have been fixed before deciding to start reconciling after several months. Therefore, we proceed as if there are no past mistakes. If we do uncover past mistakes later in the process, we adjust accordingly as we see them. So, let's imagine you started entering transactions at the beginning of using QuickBooks or QuickBooks Online, and you did not know the book balance. The only difference in that case must be what was excluded only from QuickBooks. And with no evidence of past mistakes, we assume that this different amount was the book balance on the startup date. And the amount of the beginning balance adjustment should be the amount that was or should have been the book balance at the moment we started using QuickBooks. But then the question arises, what if there were undetected past mistakes? Well, even if there were past mistakes, May's beginning balance will be correct if you follow this method. No matter how many mistakes you had before you started reconciling, the first month with the correct beginning balance will be perfect. And you will be able to reconcile perfectly from that point forward going into the future. But there is one last issue, even if there are no past mistakes. What if a check that you assumed was cleared, and you marked as cleared as part of the first month bank rec process, and it was actually not cleared? What do you do if it clears after you start reconciling? Well, that simply means that your beginning book balance amount was not correct when you made your first beginning balance adjustment. So, in the month that the check really clears, you have to readjust the beginning balance to make it what it should have been if you knew about the check when you did the first month's bank rec. So, let's take a look at the diagram. You assumed all past checks had cleared and you marked them as cleared, and May's reconciliation was perfect. But there was one check that really did not clear. And that check wound up clearing after you started reconciling. So what would you do in that case if you used the method that I just told you about with the two simple steps? Well, you would then have to add a third step after the fact. Should you delete it? No. It will change the cleared balance if you delete it. Should you enter it? No. It's already entered. So what's the solution? The solution in that rare case is very simple. Make another beginning balance adjustment to the bank rec in the month that the past check really does clear. The amount of the adjustment is the amount of the recently cleared check that was mistakenly marked as cleared. Had you known about this uncleared check, you would not have cleared it at the beginning, excuse me, you would not have cleared it, and the beginning balance adjustment would have been different because you would have chosen not to clear this check. So adjust for that amount when finishing the bank rec of the month that the mistaken check has cleared. The dates of both adjustments is the QuickBooks startup date for that bank account. In other words, you didn't really know what the book balance was until all the checks that you marked as cleared really did clear. Now that you know that, now that all those checks have cleared, now you know the real amount of the beginning book balance, and that's why the date of that adjustment is the startup date. It's the same date as the original beginning balance adjustment.